Hello everyone, welcome back once again to this new tarot reading. This time I'm going to continue with the different readings, general readings, and this time it's scene B turn. So I'm going to be talking about her general energies, personality traits, and then a bit of what's to come in the next 6 months or so for her. So I'm going to start with the archetype cards. For her, the cards that came out when it comes to archetype, it's the Exorcist, the Alchemist, and the Damsel. When you have these kind of archetypes, I do believe that she is the kind of person that is able to transform her own destiny. It's like someone that is able to kind of depure, cleanse. It's like a way of diminishing the probabilities of things going the wrong way in her life. It's like, because the Exorcist archetype talks about when you are able to be a kind of, it's like you master the ability to cleanse the air, to cleanse the possibility, to cleanse your surrounding in a way that it allows you to see possibilities. Maybe in her early years, maybe, I know she is young, but maybe when she started in all this idol journey, it was obviously, we know it's very competitive and we know that they do work really hard to get to where they are. But it's like when you're an exorcist, it means that you can overcome and sometimes being able to transform maybe bad influences, bad energies, and sometimes maybe some bad experiences that you may encounter, or maybe some people that are not really nice. It's like you can be able to transform and transcend all those challenges. And you transform them, and it's like you exorcise them. And when you exorcise, it's like you take the garbage out. It's like you cleanse yourself, you cleanse your circumstances, and you turn the odds to your favor. So this is what it means. And also because it, the next card we have is the Alchemist, which is also a card that talks about being in control of your own destiny, being able to make the right choices for you, even though when sometimes it feels like things don't work out necessarily the way you want them to, but it's like you are, she is wise enough to realize that everything happens for a reason, and that she can overcome a lot of things by changing her mindset, or maybe being a bit like having this ability to adjust to whatever is coming her way. It's like she definitely has control over her circumstances, and it's like she is someone that takes really seriously her own actions and her words. She has a great memory. She knows everyone. It's like she remembers everything that has been said or done to her. So in this sense, it's like she's really wise, because she takes power of of sometimes situations where maybe other people in her place might have fallen apart already. But she doesn't let it get that far. It's like she's always welcoming challenges because she thinks that it builds her character, that it builds her personality, that it gives her a strength, so that she doesn't see maybe challenges. She doesn't see them as maybe from a victim kind of point of view. She doesn't victimize herself. She's like, okay, whatever is happening to me, I'm going to master it, and I'm going to master this task, and I'm going to be the best I can be because I know I can be. So, and the last card of the archetypes is the damsel card. So it means that despite of her tough exterior, she's very ladylike. She's very, and she uses these feminine traits to get what she wants. It's like, she's not naive in that sense, that she understands the influence her looks have, and she knows how to use them. She knows how to, especially when she has to ask for favors. It's like, but it's not just to ask favors per se. It's just a way of sometimes acting like she's clueless about stuff, just so she can get help from others. Or maybe, it's a way to avoid being asked for help. It's like, she understands that in this industry, and sometimes in a lot of workplaces, when you are too helpful, when you are too willing to help, and when you are too eager to want to help everyone, it's like then you are taken advantage of. So sometimes she finds she it's like she learned that all her skills and all her knowledge and everything she has accomplished, she has done it on her own, in a sense. So it's like sometimes when people ask for things, she's like, oh, I don't know how to do that, for example. And it's like maybe they are like, oh, I heard that you are really good at this. Maybe you can help me. And she's like, no, I actually don't know. I don't know how to do this. It's like she pretends she's like this damsel in distress, just to avoid being constantly asked for favors, because she's like she knows that sometimes being too willing to want to satisfy everyone and being willing to always wanting to help, it leads to very tough situations, and she saw other people being taken advantage of. She saw a lot of people sacrificing their own shiny moment or their own talents so they can give it away to others. And she doesn't want that to happen to herself. It's like she knows she has to hold her ground. She knows she has to be very aware and very protective of her tools, of her of what she knows, because this is what makes her who she is. Because if she were too willing to share all her secrets and all her tips, it's like she would become one of many others. And she doesn't want to be in that role. She wants to be able to make wise choices, especially in an environment that she saw a lot of cheating. She saw a lot of people taking advantage of others, so by asking them to do favors. So it's like she doesn't want to put herself in that. So sometimes she acts like she's a bit naive about things, so people stop asking her for advice or for help. It may sound like she's a bit selfish, but actually she's not selfish. She's been cautious because she understands that sometimes female idols get, sometimes they are being taken for granted. For granted, it's like, oh yes, yeah, you are female, you don't know anything. So it's like, she's like, yes, I know a lot of things. I know I'm smart. I know I can do a lot of things, but I don't want to give my power to you. So that's why I hide it. She has this tendency of hiding things, you know, because she doesn't want to give her power away. So it's kind of a survival mode. She's kind of in a survival mode. So maybe she, in the past, she has been in these situations where she felt she had to defend herself, and where she felt that she had to hide somehow, and she had to disguise herself in order to not being a victim. So that's what came out. And for the tarot reading for the next 6 months, the cards that came out are the Three of Coins, the Seven of Swords, the Temperance, the Eight of Coins, the Wheel of Fortune, the Nine of Coins, the Magician, the Fool, and the Six of Cups. So it's, some cards are very similar to Umji, the first member I did a reading on. And I find it a bit funny that it's like, I believe that, I have to see the others, but I think that maybe they had talked with each other about owning this kind of similar energies. Because the Three of Coins, it's all about working as a team, putting efforts together. They definitely know that they have to be more united than ever, that they have to be really diligent when it comes to their work, that they have to work really hard, that they have to keep practicing, and that they have to come back whenever they can come back stronger than ever. So they do not lead to any more scandalous situation to happen. So they do know that they have to be more like intelligent in that sense, and also to show a more like professional side. And they do feel pressured, of course. But she's really hardworking. And then the Seven of Swords came out, that it's also the card of running away, of hiding from others. So she's, maybe she's working on something for herself. But it also talks about this process of healing that I talked about when I did Umji reading, this necessity of her maybe participating in rehearsals and stuff, but then she eventually withdrawn and she eventually goes away. It's like she wants to be on her own. It's like she doesn't want to spend more time than necessary. She just wants to do whatever is needed from her professionally, and then it's like go back and being on her own. She needs that in order to heal, because it's like she feels like if she spends too much time with the members, that she may say something that she may regret later. So she doesn't want to hurt anyone's feelings. So that's why she prefers to keep her opinions to herself, which I believe that sometimes are a bit sharp. So, and everyone knows it. So it's like, just let her be, let her do her thing. And she is managing this this frustration by working on details, by working, becoming a workaholic, actually. It's like finding a new project or finding something to work on. I don't know if it's music-wise or if she's studying a career or something. But she's definitely putting all that frustration and all that. She seems to sense this as a block energy that she has, and it's like she needs to release it, and she needs to pour it in something that makes her feel like she is useful, and that she is like perfection in something, and something that can keep her mind away from all the negativity, because she thinks a lot. She's I believe she's a Gemini. I think she's a Gemini. And she definitely, yes, she's a Gemini with the moon in Virgo. So yes, double Mercury there. A lot of mental and intellectual energy. So she definitely has a lot of thoughts. So the best way is to put them into work, to put them into inspiration, to put them into a more material, and to be a bit expressive. Maybe she's writing, but she's creating something, and it's something that requires and demands of her a lot of attention. So it can be a new skill, maybe, that she's learning. Maybe learning a new instrument, or there's something. But she is concentrated, and that's what she's going to be in the next month. She needs to keep concentrating, because otherwise she is like she becomes a bit opinionated, and it's not the right time, because everyone is a bit sensitive, so it's not the right time to say a few things. But it's like when she gets nervous. This is what happens when she gets nervous, when she gets anxious, which they are. It's like she starts talking, and it's like she cannot stop. She cannot stop talking. It's like this self-defense mechanism that she has. So it's not that she does it in purpose. It's that she does it to hurt someone. It's just that it's the way she is. It's the way she feels inside. It's like the way to process emotions for her is to be communicative, and sometimes she can be a lot, like when it comes to words, because it's like she has a lot to say, and she that it's not like she says a phrase or an opinion and it's like okay, that's it. It's like no, she continues. So the next card that she has is the Wheel of Fortune, the Nine of Coins, and the Magician. So obviously in the next months, everything is going to start moving. They are going to enter a new cycle of this situation they are in, and they're going to be she is going to be feeling a bit more proud of herself. It's like I don't know if she's going to start seeing the results of all this practice, of this activity she was focused on before. It's like she's going to start to see its value. She's going to start to see some kind of reward, so some kind of fruits of her own efforts. So she's going to be really happy. She's going to feel really proud of herself. And also the Magician is also talking. She's someone that definitely has a lot of self-control. It's like she knows her worth, because the Magician is when you know that you have the tools, and you know that you can be wise enough to use them whenever is needed. So she's definitely a very powerful person. It's like, but she's powerful because she knows she has tools, and she knows how to use them. It's like she's really smart in that sense. She's really smart. I think her intelligence is really remarkable. I believe she's going to be a really successful businesswoman in the future, because she definitely has this it's like she knows how to negotiate. She knows when the time is right. It's like she contemplates everything. She's not someone that acts on an impulse or on a whim. She is very smart. She's very smart. So it's like really admiring to see that in her. I don't know her that much, but I can feel this mercurial energy on her. It's like this energy of being really intelligent. So it's really nice. And the last cards are the Fool and the Six of Cups. So they are going to enter a new phase. They're going to start anew again, which is not, it's like, it's not going to be entirely like it was from the beginning or like it was in the past. It's not like things are going to get back to normal right away, even though they wish it would. Things are going to start to work out for them, but slowly. It's like they're going to be have to be really like cautious and really like, I mean, taking the activities and taking this process as a way of starting again. But it's like they're not going to be able to let go easily of what happened. It's like each of the members has like a personal opinion about what happened. Since I'm only starting to see two of them and I find the similarities, I believe they are like a small, like they are a group, but there's like a small, like a smaller, they're like a duo or like a trio that they share the same points of view. So it's like they gather their own opinions and are like, oh yes, she this, she that. So there's like this, and she's really smart. It's like she knows who agrees with her and she knows who doesn't agree with her. She knows who likes her and she knows who doesn't like her. But it's like she doesn't care because she's like she has this businesswoman mentality, so she doesn't take anything like seriously. Like it takes it. Nothing affects her emotionally, actually. She's really invested intellectually, in a very intellectual way. She doesn't, it's like she's not very emotional, so it's not easy to affect her, you know, in a deep way. Because actually she's not that deep emotionally. She doesn't have like a strong feelings. It's like everything important, and the concentration of energy in her, it's in his in her mind. It's all concentrated in her mind. That's why she can be so analyzing, and she can be so calculated. She can be able to calculate everything and to be able to see details and gather ideas, because her mind is really connected to who she is, and she knows that it's her best asset, so she uses it. She could be a bit cold, that's why I think she is, she's like avoiding social interactions because she knows she will probably say something. And it's like they do not want to start drama. I mean, it's like they were advised to not start drama, to keep the opinions to themselves and to work on themselves. So she's like keeping herself busy so she doesn't find that maybe so she doesn't find herself getting like pulled to a very uncomfortable situation where she starts saying something and then we know that some people are more sensitive than others and there are people that can take it the wrong way. So it's not a good time to say something. because it's like was what had to be talked, it was talked and it was said already. So there's no need to continue in with the same conversation and with the same subject. So I'm going to finish the reading here, guys. I hope that if I'm mistaken by some kind of data or some kind of facts, maybe about her or the group, people who are their fans can let me know, so I can also educate myself about them, because I don't know much about them. So I'm starting this series of tarot reading for them to connect with their energy and also to do it in a respectful way. So thank you so much for being here, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.